Happy Inauguration Day to you as well. For all Americans, it's a happy Inauguration Day, because anytime we have an inauguration, it means that our republic still exists. And the continual, you know, renewal of there being new presidents is a process that continues. That in itself, formatically, is a good thing. Who's with me?
Well, the vast majority of the protests going on in Washington, D.C. today during Donald Trump's inauguration were peaceful. There were isolated instances of violence. We don't yet know if they were actually progressives or liberals, or if they were just provocateurs sent there by the right wing. But we're going to show you, if we can bring up the B-roll pictures here, you're going to see shots, some of what looks like it might be violence. Oh, this is good, too. You're seeing there various things being thrown by police and things like that to try to clear out the group. You're seeing a huge amount of police and riot gear there.
Yeah,
this is just one spot, but there were instances like this in other parts of D.C.
Look, I can't stand this stuff. Whatever, the whole thing, yeah. So, look, they could accuse me of being comfortable and saying, and well, you're not out there protesting and stuff like that. And no. Protests I'm in favor of. Okay, in fact, I got arrested doing a protest where we did civil disobedience, right? But I want America on our side. You know, you start doing all this mass stuff and you're causing violence, you're only feeding to Trump's hand. I mean, I don't generally believe in, I mean, of course there is a thing called a false flag operation. I don't think that it's necessarily going on here. But if you wanted to plan a false flag operation, this is how you would do it.
Well, that hatred shown towards Donald Trump has grown amid much of the mainstream media's critical coverage against him. Most recently, CNN's been reporting what would happen should disaster strike during Trump's inauguration.
What if an incoming president and his immediate successors were wiped out on day one?
Who would be in charge if an attack hit the incoming president? It won't be a Trump cabinet secretary. It will be an Obama appointee.
It is patently irresponsible. Dare I say it is criminal. Do you have any idea of how many nutcases we have walking around here? People who have absolutely nothing to live for. People who have been riled into this sense of absolute froth over this president-elect who has been called by some illegitimate, and you have this show where you're basically providing a prescription? You're basically tacitly saying, you know, this is what would happen if, God forbid, somebody were to off the president and the vice president. Why? If it would happen, it would be pretty much just the way it was before. Do you know how little it takes to get some attention-starved lone wolf, some demented, psychopathic, homicidal lunatic to empower and to propel them into maybe taking one for the team? This is just inconceivable.
Inconceivable.
What's wrong with Pepe?
It stands for...
Are you guys offended by a cartoon frog?
Do you have a trick up?
Shit, I paid the way, boy, to the early
God. Okay, we're going the other way. It is total anarchy in the streets right now. They're blowing things up. There's mace going. They've got tons of mace going. Right down here, they're spraying all of them.
Look, we know that there were right-wing groups like, was it Project Veritas? Is that what he's called? Keith, what's his name? James O'Keefe and whatever, trying to pay people to cause trouble during the inauguration. This is something that right-wingers do. So I would not be shocked if there were provocateurs out there. We don't know who these individuals are, but we do know one thing, and that is that the mission of true progressives, true liberals, is a peaceful one.
Peaceful one.
Now, I will not make an excuse for anyone who uses violence during any of these protests, but I will say this. I find it interesting what the media's response is to people breaking windows and how quickly they denounce that kind of violence when simultaneously we will be bombarded with police shooting videos where we will see someone like Walter Scott running away from a police officer as he gets shot several times in the back. And that type of violence doesn't get denounced as quickly. Oh, we don't know all the evidence yet. We don't know all the evidence yet.
Walter Scott once smoked marijuana.
Right. So look, violence in any circumstance is unacceptable. But think about the violence that we are now desensitized to versus the type of, you know, vandalism we're very, very sensitive to.
Wow. Do not allow anyone to tell you that it cannot be done. No challenge can match the heart and fight and spirit of America. We will not fail. Our country will thrive and prosper again. We stand at the birth of a new millennium, ready to unlock the mysteries of space, to free the earth from the miseries of disease, and to harness the energies, industries, and technologies of tomorrow. A new national pride will stir our souls, lift our sights, and heal our divisions. It's time to remember that old wisdom our soldiers will never forget. That whether we are black or brown or white, we all bleed the same red blood of patriots.